What can we learn as business people about this successful man who had over 1,000 U.S. patents, over 1,200 international patents, who, as you'll see shortly, established six industries in less than 35 years? There are ways to be successful at innovation that don't just involve luck or chance, but there are actually processes and methods and creativity techniques that can be implemented in real time that will drive that. A lot of what Edison did was timeless, so the innovation approaches that he took are equally valuable in our time as they were in his time. I am a great grandniece of Thomas Edison and learned that when I was about 8 years old. Most of what we have learned about Edison, despite the 70 books that have been written about him, come through the eyes of the historian. They don't come through the lens of business. Innovation is the game changer in the global economy, because innovation is how we create new things. It is also how we can re-accelerate and reignite growth.
It's such a pleasure to be here in the land of Edison, an extraordinarily prolific inventor and innovator. How did he do that? This morning, we will look at some of the processes and the methods that he used to be so successful in the realm of innovation.
Sarah's in tune with the innovation needs of today. We're in an economic recession where if we're going to improve over the long term, we need to invest in creativity and innovation.
The most valuable thing I took out of it was just how creative he was. A lot of the principles are applicable no matter what age you are, and something we can apply today in our business models.
So I'd like to turn and talk with you now about what I call Edison's five competencies of innovation. These are the patterns and sequences that I was seeing in Edison's process, the things that he was repeating over and over again in his 62-year career. Now, each of these competencies is a blend of skills, processes, and mindsets. So it's not just what we do, it's also about how we think.
I was fascinated by the connectivity that Sarah made in terms of looking at historic just milestones that our country has been able to surpass and connecting those to innovations that we are so excited about today.
The ideas are wonderful, but she was able to bring it home to how can it be relevant to our communities.
It's so inspirational, educational, informative.
I enjoyed it. I think it was truly on point, and from the audience response, I thought it was very well received.
One of the places that we always begin as we think about innovation is ideas. And who had more ideas than Thomas Edison? He said, "I would like to live about 300 years. I think I have ideas enough to keep me busy that long." It's crucial that we move beyond ideas to action. Edison was a master at this. One of his most famous quotes reads this way: "Genius is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration." Certainly, the ideas are 1% of what we need. 99% is the actual execution. It's the actual moving forward with the idea. It's stepping out into the unknown. It's leading people into a space where they have never been before.
I actually thought it was very inspirational and inspired me in several ways.
I really liked her thoughts about engagement, about engaging everyone in the community and engaging multidisciplinary groups.
Really looking at the broad, big picture. And I think that that's something that our community really thrives on, is collaboration, talking to each other, talking among the various sectors, making sure that we're all on the same page, just generating that excitement.